to sort of get good footage and not to sort of teach curse to the sharp end. But since that to be like 30 centimeters away, it was really difficult. So I found the easiest way to get in on the shark, where the sharks are feeding, was actually to just swim alongside and just like gently hold the dorsal and let the shark actually guide me when it came in onto the whale to guide me in with it to get the shot. So, and I see it, all other divers are like swimming off in every direction, trying to get out of my way. But I think that's the only way I could get some of the really, like some of the good shots that I got in. There was particularly one great bite that I watched him go around the carcass left, because going anti-clockwise, and he'd come up and take a bite on the same spot, and he'd go around again, same spot, go around again. So I decided, okay, this is the guy. Grab his fin, pulls me up onto the carcass, start filming. He turned off left every time, he turned off left. So I came in on the right hand side, forming,
do you want it?
Into me right. What a nice feeling. And then he swim around the carcass again, left, left, come up, take a bite, turn off left. Okay, try again. Come up, left, turns right, back into me again.
Yes!
On all fish. But anyway, I didn't die. Very persistent, so I started when I was like just over maybe 5 and a half or so. And there were a couple of other lifeguards that I really looked up to that were, you know, some lovely stories. And one of the things I always heard them talking about was like riding on dolphins. So it was my, it was the start of my sort of crazy chase of dolphins and sharks. You know, they talk about sharks, seeing sharks on their swims, and you know, and riding the dolphins' fins, man, it's like, yes, it sounded so amazing to me. It was like, probably from when I was 6 years old, it was my life's ambition to just grab on a dolphin and get a ride. I think these guys explained. And it took me years and years and years. I must have swum 100 kilometers.